So today we are going to see how to use Teachable Flutter package developed by me to make a pose classifier which can classify poses based on the models which we can train. So yeah, this is the basic version, which was kind of test version uploaded by me on pub.dev, and this is newer version which will be released soon. At the time you will be watching the video, it will be released by then. So this is basically it's readme, which is completely the section which is to be followed. So here this is the HTML code. So what you have to do is you have to copy it, and you have to put it into some HTML file where you have to store this HTML file. So this is the example. I'm showing you on the browser itself so that you don't get confused. So this is the pose folder of this example. Here it is index.html. So now here I have uploaded the URL, but here in readme you can see you have to upload your own URL. So we will see how to generate this URL for yourself or for a specific another purpose. So once you do this, so now the next thing is you have to get the permission handler plugin. It is currently in version 8.1.2 at the time of recording, but at your time you have to use the most recent version. So in example, we can say in lib folder in main, it is the same way. You have to first ensure it is initialized, then you have to ask for those permissions and beforehand, and these are basic permissions for Android which are mandatory to be added to your Android manifest.xml. So for iOS I don't know much, because this is done on a Windows machine, but I have mentioned the links from for the plugins which are used while developing this package. So now it is the time to create our own model. So for creating our own model, what we have to do is we have to go at Teachable Machines, then we have to click on Get Started. We have to go for Pose Project, because our main thing is to create a pose classifier. So now I have created already, I have selected some data. So this is the data from where you are going to train your model. Okay. So by mistake I clicked enter button. So this is not the one. Okay, it was one of those. My bad, that's not the one. Okay. So once you are in your folder, you have to classify, you have to add this all images. It will add all those images. Then you have to change its name, because these are the names which will be used in your Flutter project. So now I'm changing it to Warrior 1. And my next pose is tree pose. So now for this purpose you have to go for the next model data. So the only thing you have to do is you have to collect all those photos and be ready with the segregation. Now next thing is just click on train model. So now the model will be start training, and while it is training, now we can't switch also. Okay. Yeah, the best part is you can add as many classes as you want. It is I am currently for this video recording it on two classes, but you can do anything. You can create a yoga classifier, or you can create anything. Like you can use it for tuitions where you have to check the stance of your student or something like that. So this plugin is for it. It was specifically developed for classifying yoga poses. So that is the most basic use case it satisfies. Okay, it is done 50%. It is still remaining. Okay, now you can see the model is trained. Currently it is doing a mistake, so let me just switch off the webcam. Okay, so now what we have to do is we have to export our model. Now just now it is the time where we discussed about the URL. So for that you have to upload your model, and while once it gets uploaded you will get the shareable link. So this is the link which is to be put in your URL section. Okay, so then it's taking its time. Okay, so now it has done uploading model to its servers. So now you have to copy this URL. You can close this tab now. Okay, no need. Now in index.html you have to replace that section with your URL. And now once you are done, you can just close index.html. Now we have to use the model. So yeah. So this is the model. So now you can see this is the path which is mentioned to it. So you have to mention this path, and this is the results function. So here you can see the rest is the it is JSON data. So now I'm classifying it into I'm changing the JSON data. I'm decoding it, and now I'm using the tree pose. And if you run this code, you will see the output which you saw at the beginning of the video. Okay, thank you guys. So if you found this useful, don't forget to like this video, and new plugins will be coming out. So if you want to explore new plugins which will enhance your project and ease your programming, so don't forget to subscribe to this channel.